When I worked for a nonprofit, I started a marine debris program to help disentangle corals from fishing gear that was left behind. Now my best friend runs it. Come watch our process. She signaled to me the entangled coral and is now spotting me from above. As I cut the monofilament line away from the coral, I'm making sure not to pull at all. And as a disclaimer, I should be wearing gloves. Entanglement in fishing line is a source for mortality in Hawaii's coral reefs. This is why sustainable fishing practices are so important.
Fishing gear hurts a lot of different things in the ocean, but coral reefs are just one. And so single monofilament fishing line, if it gets wrapped around it, you know, it can become encrusted, especially if it's there for a long time, and it can just add unneeded stress to the coral that is already experiencing stress from temperatures or acidification. They're clear, often translucent. They're very thin. You know, if it's been there a while, it usually has algae growing on it, which is how I identify it. And you can do a lot of damage if you're not educated on how to disentangle corals. And so corals that I observe in the water that might have a lot of fishing line deeply encrusted in it, I will leave that one alone because I might be doing more damage if I am pulling on the coral. Sustainable fishing to me is small scale, it's artisanal, it's where fishers are fishing for their livelihoods and are able to share that with their community. Industrial fishing is where you're more likely to come into those complications of like heavy gear being left behind and heavy bycatch rates, which is where marine animals are killed accidentally.